गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ रासा इंटरनेशनल स्कूल टू स्टडी साइंस चैप्टर नंबर 1 मैटर इन आर सराउंडिंग्स। वी विल डू टुडे द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑन बुक पेज नंबर 9। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डू द कन्वर्जन ऑफ केल्विन टू सेल्सियस स्केल। सो दीज आर द यूनिट्स टू मेजर टेम्परेचर। Okay, one is the Kelvin scale, the other one is the degree Celsius scale. Now how they are related is, the value, suppose you have 300 Kelvin. Okay, this is the value temperature in Kelvin scale. Now if you want to convert into degree Celsius scale, you have to subtract 273 from the value of Kelvin scale. Okay, so you will get 27 degree Celsius. Okay, so what would be the formula? The formula will be the value in degree Celsius scale is equal to value in Kelvin scale minus 273. Okay, so in this way they are related. So let us do the questions. Okay, so the degree value in Celsius is equal to value in Kelvin scale minus 273 is equal to 27 degree Celsius. Similarly, 573 in Kelvin scale minus 273 is equal to 300 degree Celsius. Okay, now we have to discuss the physical state of water at 250 degree Celsius and 100 degree Celsius. Now first of all, the freezing point of water is 0 degree Celsius and the melting point is also 0 degree Celsius. Now what is freezing? The water from the liquid state convert into solid state at 0 degree Celsius, as well as the water, the solid ice, okay, will melt at 0 degree Celsius to convert into liquid state. At the same time, 100 degree Celsius is the boiling point, okay, of water. So it is at this the water start converting into vapor state. So I can say that at 0 degree Celsius water can be in solid state as well as in liquid state. Both these states can be possible. Okay, so we can't exactly say that it is solid or liquid, so we can say either of solid or of liquid. On the other hand, at 100 degree Celsius I can say that the state of water can be liquid or gaseous. Clear? So now discuss with that. 250 degree Celsius means it is above 100 degree Celsius, so water will be in gaseous state. Water will be in gaseous state because the temperature is more than 100 degree Celsius. At 100 degree Celsius we already discussed the water can exist in both liquid and gaseous state. So any of these state can be possible. So at this temperature, after getting heat equal to the latent heat of vaporization, water start changing from liquid to state of gaseous state. Clear? Now question number 3. For any substance, why do the temperature remain constant during the change in state? किसी भी substance का temperature same क्यों रहता है जब वो उसकी state change हो रही होती है? So the answer will be, during the state change, the temperature remain constant because all the heat supplied is to increase, okay, the temperature is utilized in changing the state by overcoming the force of attraction between the particle. जो उस वक्त heat supply हो रही है वो उसका temperature नहीं बढ़ा रही, बल्कि क्या कर रही है, उसके intermolecular जो attraction है या interparticles जो force of attraction है उसको overcome करने में जा रही है. So therefore this heat does not contribute in increasing the temperature of the substance, but it overcoming the force of attraction between the particles. Clear? That is why the temperature remains constant. Okay. Suggest the method to liquefy the atmospheric gas. We know that by increasing the pressure and decreasing the temperature, by increasing the pressure and reducing the temperature or decreasing the temperature, the atmospheric gas can be liquefied. Why? By increasing the pressure, we confine the gas into smaller volume, but due to which the collision between the particles increases, due to which temperature increases. That is why we have to lower down the temperature also, so that by increasing the pressure, we have to decrease the temperature also, so that the gas get liquefied. Okay, the increasing the pressure or reducing the temperature alone can't do liquefaction of the gas. Thank you.